There was this really depressing study that came out in 2002 that said that a full third of Americans never read another book after high school. That 70% of adults hadn't been in a bookstore in 5 years. That 80% of US families did not buy or read a book in the last year. Well, a lot has changed since 2002. Millennials, my generation, and Gen Z, your generation, are much more likely to have an active library card than any generation before us. By every measure, young people are reading more. So why do I yell at you to read a book? It's kind of my catchphrase. I even got the t-shirt. I actually didn't make it up though. My English teacher, Mr. Martin, used to yell it at me.
That's him.
So yeah, I'm an English teacher, and yeah, I want you to read a book because it's part of class, but believe it or not, the real reason why I say read a book has nothing to do with school. It's all about being a person, being a human being. This is the first Spider-Man comic book I ever read. I got it on vacation when I was really bored, when I think I was 11 years old in 2002, and it was the issue that Spider-Man became a public high school teacher at the school he went to high school. This had a profound effect on me. I don't think I realized that it made me want to be a teacher until about 15 years later. And it's just a comic book. When you find a book that you really love, you're going to internalize those characters. We call that imaginative rehearsal in English sometimes. For example, Pride and Prejudice is about this girl named Elizabeth Bennet. And I'm going to carry Lizzie Bennet with me for the rest of my life. I can't tell you how many times I thought, am I being a Lizzie Bennet? Because she was prideful and prejudiced, and it helps me catch myself when I'm feeling maybe prideful or maybe prejudiced. This is my favorite author, David Foster Wallace. Now, there's this big joke in the English world that David Foster Wallace's fans are really pretentious and stuff like that, and they're not wrong, but he is a great author. When I read Dave, everything feels really clear. I know who I want to be, and it helps to see the world through Dave's eyes for a little bit. Dave's famous for this one quote: "How odd I can have all this inside me, and to you it's just words." What that means is that we all have this rich interior life in our brains, and the only way to communicate it to anyone in the outside world is through words. No one can ever truly penetrate who you are, but the closest we can get is through the written and the spoken word.
How do we understand our lives? Well, you tell your life story, right? You choose to include important events. You choose to leave others out. You write a narrative.
I'll leave you with another quote. Franz Kafka, really weird author. He said, "I think we ought to only read the kind of books that wound and stab us. But we need books that affect us like a disaster, that grieve us deeply, like the death of someone we loved more than ourselves, like being banished into forests far from everyone, like a suicide." When Kafka says we need to read books that wound and stab us, we need to read books that get inside of us, that affect us deeply. All kinds of art can do this. Film, music, books. And as an English teacher, it's my job to promote one of those. I think it's the easiest one to skip out on because sometimes it demands far more of you than movies or music. So if you take one thing away from my class, other than the fact that Elvis died on the toilet, because that always seems to be the one thing kids remember, it's this.